Now, the quantitative aspect of electrolysis. Already we know that during the electrolysis, oxidation takes place at the anode and the reduction takes place at the cathode. Always you remember this shortcut. Okay. Now, we'll take during the electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate solution, copper is deposited at the cathode. Already we know this one. So here copper is deposited at the cathode means copper undergo reduction at the cathode so that it gains electron and copper is deposited at the cathode here. So the product obtained at the cathode is what? Copper deposited. Here you see here copper plus 2 ion, it gains 2 electron so that copper is deposited. Every 1 mole of copper plus 2 ion gains 2 moles of electron so that 1 mole of copper is deposited at the cathode. So, in order to produce 63 gram of copper at the cathode, you have to supply 2 moles of electrons. If the number of electrons are less than 2 moles, then the copper deposited at the cathode will be less than 63 gram. Because for every 1 mole of copper deposited, you have to supply 2 moles of electron. 2 moles of electrons are required to deposit the copper here, 1 mole of copper. If the number of electrons are less than 2 mole, then the copper produced is also less than the 63 gram. It means that the product formed at the electrode depends on the number of electrons passed, which in turn depends on what? Quantity of electricity. So how much amount of electricity you are passing, that much amount of copper is deposited. Always you keep in mind, every 2 moles of electrons deposit what? 1 mole of copper here. Now, the charge on one electron is, we know that 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb here. The charge on one mole of electrons is, just you multiply this one with 6.022 into 10 power 23. That is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 into 6.022 into 10 power 23. So, the answer comes out to be 96,488, which is nearly equal to 96,500 coulomb per mole. This is the very important value. 96,500 coulomb, it is the charge present on the 1 mole. 96,500 coulombs per mole it is. So, what is the charge on 1 mole of electrons? That is 96,500 coulomb per mole. You have to remember this one. This is very important to solve the problems. Now, the charge on 1 mole of electrons, that is 96,500 coulomb, this will be equal to 1 Faraday. That is taken as what? 1 Faraday. Always, 1 Faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. Now, what is the charge on the n mole of electrons? 1 mole of electrons is having charge of 96,500 coulomb. So, the charge on the n mole of electrons will be is equal to n into Faraday. So, that is n into 96,500 coulomb here. Now, this charge Q, it is calculated from the strength of the current I and the time for which electricity is passed, that is T here. So, electric current will be is equal to what? I is equal to Q by T here. I is what? Current in amperes and Q is the charge in the coulombs and T will be time in seconds here. Suppose one coulomb of charge flows for 1 second, then it is equal to what? 1 ampere of current here. Therefore, one coulomb will be equal to what? 1 ampere into 1 second. If 1 ampere current flows for 1 second, then it is equal to what? 1 coulomb here. Now we will discuss quantitative aspect of electrolysis. Already we know that during the electrolysis, oxidation takes place at the anode and the reduction takes place at the cathode. If I take the electrolysis of aqueous solution of copper sulfate, during the electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate solution, copper is deposited at the cathode. So, here the charge on the copper is what? Plus 2. Each 1 mole of copper plus 2 ion, they gains 2 mole of electrons so that 1 mole of copper will be deposited at the cathode. 1 mole of copper is nothing but 63 gram. Atomic mass of copper is 63 gram. To deposit 63 gram of the copper at the cathode, you have to supply 2 moles of electron. Because every 1 mole of copper plus 2 ion gains 2 moles of electron, then 1 mole of copper will be deposited. If the number of electrons are less than 2 mole, then the copper deposited at the cathode will be less than 63 gram. Because the copper deposited at the cathode, it depends on what? The number of electrons that are passed here. So, always you keep in mind, the product which is formed at the cathode or anode, that depends on the number of electrons that are passed through the electrolytic solution. So the product formed at the electrode depends on the number of electrons passed, which in turn depends on what? Quantity of electricity. Quantity of electricity decides how much amount of product will be formed at the respective electrode here. Now the charge on the one electron is what? -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb here. So the charge on the one mole of electrons will be taken as what? This charge on the electron is multiplied with this 6.022 × 10⁷. So charge on the one mole of electrons is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ × 6.022 × 10⁷. This value comes out to be 96,488, which is nearly equal to 96,500. We will round off this one. So the charge on the one mole of electrons will be 96,500 coulomb per mole. Now the charge on the one mole of electron, that is 96,500 coulomb, this is taken as 1 Faraday. 1 Faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. If charge on the one mole of electron is 96,500 coulomb, then the charge on the n mole of electrons will be q is equal to n into f. F is nothing but 1 Faraday. 1 Faraday is nothing but what? 96,500 coulomb. So n into 96,500 coulomb, this will be the charge on the n mole of electrons. Now this q will be calculated from the strength of the current I and the time for which electricity is passed, that is t here. So electric current I will be is equal to what? Q by t here. I is what? Current in amperes, and q is what? Charge in the coulombs, and t is time in the seconds here. Now if 1 coulomb of charge flows for 1 second, that will be equal to 1 ampere of current here. Therefore, if you rearrange this one, 1 coulomb of charge will be is equal to 1 ampere of current that is flowing for 1 second. If 1 ampere current flows for 1 second, that will be equal to 1 coulomb here. So we know that the product formed at the particular electrode, that depends on the number of electrons passed here. So in this case, Na plus ion, each 1 mole of Na plus ion, they will gain 1 mole of electrons. So that 1 mole of sodium will be deposited at the electrode. 1 mole of sodium is nothing but 23 gram. So 1 mole of electrons are passed, 23 gram of sodium will be deposited at the electrode, at the cathode. So what is the charge on the 1 mole of electrons here? 96,500 coulomb. If you pass 96,500 coulomb of charge, 23 gram of sodium will be deposited. So 96,500 coulomb will be nothing but 1 Faraday. 1 Faraday of the current will deposit 23 gram of the sodium at the respective cathode. So what is the equivalent weight of the sodium here? For radicals, equivalent weight will be molecular weight by charge. What is the charge on the sodium? 1 here. So its atomic weight is 23 divided by 1. So equivalent weight of sodium is what? 23 gram. So 1 Faraday of current is depositing equivalent weight of the sodium. Equivalent weight of sodium is what again? 23 gram here. Next, if you go for copper, each copper plus 2 ion, it gains 2 electrons. So that copper will be deposited at the cathode. Each 1 mole of copper plus 2 ion gains 2 moles of electrons, then 1 mole of copper will be deposited at the cathode. So what is the charge on the 2 moles of electron? 2 into 96,500 coulomb. So whenever 2 into 96,500 coulomb of charge is passed, 63 gram of the copper will be deposited. 63 gram is what? Atomic mass of the copper. 1 mole of copper is equal to 63 gram here. So this will be nothing but 2 Faraday of current deposits 63 gram of the copper at the electrode. Then 1 Faraday of the current will deposit how much? That is 63 divided by 2. This is nothing but the equivalent weight of this copper, that is nothing but molecular weight by charge for the radicals. This is the equivalent weight, 63 divided by 2. So 31.5 gram of copper will be deposited by 1 Faraday of the current. So you can conclude here, in presence of 1 Faraday of the current, equivalent weight of the substance will be deposited. Here also same thing, 1 Faraday deposits what? Equivalent weight of sodium. Here 1 Faraday deposits how much? Equivalent weight of the copper. So 63 divided by 2, that is atomic mass divided by its charge, nothing but valency. This ratio is nothing but equivalent weight, that is 31.5 gram of copper is deposited. 2 Faraday deposits 63 gram. 1 Faraday deposits 31.5 gram. That is, in presence of 1 Faraday of the current, equivalent weight of the substance is deposited. Again, it can be proved by this example, Al plus 3 ion. Each 1 mole of Al plus 3 ion, they will gain 3 moles of electron here. So that 1 mole of aluminium will be deposited. 1 mole of aluminium is nothing but how much? That is 27 gram. Here 1 mole of aluminium will be deposited. So 3 moles of electron, what is the charge on the 3 mole of electron? 3 into 96,500 coulomb. Whenever you pass this quantity of charge, 27 gram of aluminium will be deposited at the cathode. So 3 Faraday deposits, 27 gram. So 1 Faraday deposits how much? 27 divided by 3. This will be the equivalent weight of aluminium. That is nothing but molecular weight by charge, here atomic weight by charge, that is 9 gram. So always 1 Faraday of the current deposits equivalent weight of the substance. Therefore, in presence of 1 Faraday of the current, equivalent weight of substance will be deposited or liberated in the electrolysis process. So what happens here? 1 Faraday of the current, it deposits equivalent weight of any substance. 1 Faraday is how much here? 96,500 coulomb. Always it deposits equivalent weight of the substance. If 96,500 coulomb deposits equivalent weight, then 1 coulomb deposits how much? That will be taken as Z value. Z is nothing but here electrochemical equivalence we call it as. So here Z will be is equal to what here? That will be equivalent weight divided by 96,500. You have to cross multiply these two here. So what is equivalent weight here? Molecular weight divided by valency, and this is written as it is 1 by 96,500 coulomb. So the formula for Z will be what? Equivalent weight divided by 96,500. What is Z here? It is the mass of the substance deposited or liberated when 1 coulomb of charge flows for 1 second it is. 96,500 coulomb deposits equivalent weight, then 1 coulomb deposits how much? That is the Z value. Z is equal to equivalent weight by 96,500. Equivalent weight can be written as what? Molecular weight by valency into 1 by 96,500 coulomb. This is written as it is. So this is very, very important. Z, this formula you have to remember here. Z is equal to equivalent weight divided by 96,500 coulomb here. Now, what is this Z? Electrochemical equivalence. Z is the mass of the substance deposited or liberated at the electrode when 1 coulomb of charge flows for 1 second. Always you keep in mind, 96,500 coulomb deposits equivalent weight. 1 coulomb deposits, that is Z value. Z is electrochemical equivalence. Now we will discuss Faraday's laws of electrolysis. First one is Faraday's first law of electrolysis. According to Faraday's first law of electrolysis, the mass of the substance deposited or liberated at the particular electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity that is passed through the electrolytic solution. So here the mass of the substance depends on what here? The quantity of electricity that is passed through the electrolytic solution. Mass of the substance deposited is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed. Q is equal to IT. So M is directly proportional to IT. If I remove this proportionality sign, this formula become as M is equal to Z into IT. Z is proportional constant, that is called as electrochemical equivalence. Already we know the value of Z here. If you substitute the value of Z, the formula become as M is equal to molecular weight by valency into 1 by 96,500 coulomb into IT. So this formula is very, very important to solve the problems based on the Faraday's first law of electrolysis. In this formula, M is mass of the substance deposited, Z is electrochemical equivalence, I is current in amperes, T is time in seconds, and Q is charge in the coulombs here. M is equal to Z into IT. If I is equal to 1 ampere and T is equal to 1 second, then M is equal to what? Z here. If 1 ampere of current flows for 1 second, then the mass of the substance deposited or liberated, that will be equal to what? Electrochemical equivalence. M is equal to Z here. Next one. Faraday's second law of electrolysis. According to Faraday's second law of electrolysis, whenever the same quantity of electricity is passed through different electrolytic cells which are connected in the series, then the mass of the substance deposited or liberated at the electrode is directly proportional to their equivalent weight. So mass of the substance deposited or liberated is directly proportional to their equivalent weight here. Okay. In this one, these three cells are connected in the series. Here I have taken molten NaCl. This is aqueous zinc chloride and this is aqueous copper sulfate. In this one, sodium is deposited at the cathode, chlorine is liberated at the anode. Here, hydrogen is liberated at the cathode, chlorine gas is liberated at the anode. In this one, copper is deposited at the cathode and oxygen gas is liberated at the anode. From this one, we can write, from the above, mass of the sodium deposited is directly proportional to equivalent weight of sodium. Mass of chlorine is directly proportional to equivalent weight of chlorine. Mass of the copper is directly proportional to equivalent weight of copper. Mass of the oxygen liberated is directly proportional to what? Equivalent weight of the oxygen. So from 1 and 2 I can write, mass of the sodium divided by mass of chlorine is equal to equivalent weight of sodium divided by equivalent weight of chlorine. From 3 and 4 we can write that mass of the copper divided by mass of oxygen is equal to equivalent weight of copper divided by equivalent weight of oxygen. See one hint here, that is, whenever the same quantity of electricity is passed through the different electrolytic cells which are connected in the series, then the mass of the substance deposited is directly proportional to its equivalent weight. Second law is, mass deposited is directly proportional to equivalent weight. This is the hint here. Okay, from this one only we have written these different possibilities. This is about Faraday's first law and second law of electrolysis.